there and get stuck working. I don't know if you have a track with the fast lane.
could be any overspread on it. It's going to be a hard line. It's not going to look at it. A little bit wouldn't hurt, but you, you know, it has to be feathered in.
Yeah.
That mine over there, I built it. I still have to put the decals on and weather it. So I'll probably start something better like that. Yeah. Yeah. So the inside of those windows are probably supposed to be real dirty. So I don't know how much I really need to actually cover them up.
Not to keep track of.
Oh, yeah. I guess it's really hard to get started, but once it's started, it makes things flow real nice.
Those Alcos C648, the 30s with sound in?
I got a U25C with sound too that I'm going to bring up eventually. Yeah, I just got them all speed matched. It's just the front gearbox on the truck in the U25C. It's when I put it in reverse, it sounds like it's grinding on something. So I got to look into that and see what's doing it. But otherwise, when it's going forward, all of them run together and it's loud. I got two speakers in the U-boat, and I've got one each in the Alcos, so there's four speakers total.
Yeah, enough room in that one engine to get two speakers in there?
Well, yeah, the factory one, it came with a mount for a round speaker, and then there's enough room between the rear end and where the board sits for me to get another speaker. The guy who makes the speakers is called a Scale Set Scouts.
Yeah.
Scale Sound Systems, and he makes them custom for each engine. He 3D prints the baffles. And so I buy from him, they're only like $15 a piece. Real
I can't afford it.
There are a couple down there, Roger.
What is it?
Your SD35 same part. It's got, go and get that one. You're good.
I don't know where the hell they got that. Look at a hell of an inventory over there.